So, today's lecture is complex analysis module 3. I think it's lecture 4. A complex problem solving session tutorial complex differentiation. So, in this session, we will do three problems, KTU problems. The first problem is show that f of z is equal to e raised to minus x cos y minus e raised to minus x sin y is differentiable everywhere. Find its derivative. So first we will do that problem. Okay. So this is our problem. So we have given f of z is equal to e raised to minus x cos y minus I e raised to minus x sin y. So we have to show that this is differentiable everywhere. So how to show that? We know that if f of z satisfies two conditions, then f of z is differentiable. First condition, it must satisfy CR equation. Second condition, we have ux, uy, vx, vy are continuous. Then the function is differentiable or analytic. So here, u equal to, what is real part? U equal to e raised to minus x cos y. V equal to minus e raised to minus x sine y. Okay. So first we will check Cauchy-Riemann equation. So ux equal to, we are differentiating this with respect to x. You will get minus e raised to minus x cos y. And uy, we are differentiating this with respect to y, minus e raised to minus x cos y minus sin y, that is minus sin. And vx equal to, we are differentiating this with respect to x, e raised to minus x derivative is minus e raised to minus x. So you will get e raised to minus x, minus and minus becomes plus sin y. And vy equal to, we are differentiating this with respect to y. So this is minus e raised to minus x cos y. Okay. Now here what is ux? Minus e raised to minus x cos y. And what is vy? Minus e raised to minus x cos y. So here ux equal to vy, and what is uy? Minus e raised to minus x sin y, and vx is e raised to minus x sin y. So there is a minus. So uy must be equal to minus of v of. So this is Cauchy-Riemann equation. Therefore, f of z satisfies CR equation. So first condition satisfied. Now you have to check whether the second condition is followed. What is second condition? Ux, uy, vx, vy are continuous. So what is ux here? Here, ux is e raised to minus x cos y. We know that e raised to minus x is continuous, cos y is continuous. Exponential function and trigonometric function, cosine and sine function are continuous. Therefore, here ux is continuous, uy is continuous, vx is continuous, and vy are continuous. So here ux, uy, vx, vy are continuous. Since e raised to x, sin y, cos y are continuous. So So their product must be continuous. Therefore, f of z is, so it satisfies both conditions. Therefore, f of z is differentiable everywhere. Differentiable everywhere. So we solve this problem. So this problem is KTU December 2016. Now we will move in. We will move to next problem. So the problem is, check whether the following functions are analytic. Check whether the following functions are analytic or not. So we will use the same procedure. Okay. So justify your answer. So first we will do first problem. F of z is equal to first one, f of z equal to z plus z bar. So we know we have to check first the CR equation and second one ux, uy, vx, vy are continuous. So these are the two conditions for checking analyticity. So if z equal to x plus iy, then what is z bar conjugate is equal to x minus i bar. So we can write f of z equal to x plus i y plus x minus i y. So this should get cancelled. You will get 2x. Okay, so here there is only real part. So first we will check Cauchy-Riemann equation. Here u equal to 2x. And v equal to 0. Then what is ux? Ux equal to 2. Uy, if you differentiate this with respect to y, this is 0. And what is vx? Vx is 0. Vy equal to 0. But here ux equal to 2 and vy equal to 0. So 2 never equal to 0. Therefore, f of z does not satisfy CR equation at any point. At any point, if you take any point, this CR equation doesn't satisfy. Therefore, f of z is equal to z plus z bar is nowhere differentiable or nowhere analytic. Okay. Now we will do the second problem. The second problem here is, this is a problem is, so f of z equal to mod z square. This is KTU March 2017 question. Okay. So f of z is equal to mod z square. So z equal to x plus iy, then mod z is equal to root of x square plus y square. So this is equal to whole square is x square plus y square. So we will check Cauchy-Riemann equation. So first I will take the real part. U equal to, here real part is x square plus y square, and v equal to 0. Okay, there is no imaginary part. Then if you take ux, you will get 2x, uy, 2y, and vx, this is 0, vy equal to 0. Now we will check Cauchy-Riemann equation. So here ux equal to 2x and vy equal to 0. So qx equal to 0 only if x equal to 0. So if x equal to 0, this condition satisfies. Okay. Similarly, what will happen here? Uy equal to 2y equal to when it is equal to minus vx equal to 0. So 2y equal to 0 only if y equal to 0. So when x equal to 0, this satisfies, and y equal to 0, this condition satisfies. Therefore, if z equal to 0 plus I0, that is z equal to 0, then it satisfies Cauchy-Riemann equation. Nowhere else. Therefore, f of z satisfies CR equation only when z equal to 0. So nowhere else it satisfies Cauchy-Riemann equation. And also this ux is 2x, uy equal to 2y, vx is 0, vy equal to 0. So these are continuous function, because this is 2x, 2y, 0, 0. Constant functions are continuous and one variable polynomials are continuous. Also ux, uy, vx, vy are continuous at z equal to 0. Thus here f of z is differentiable, only when z equal to 0, nowhere else. So this function f of z equal to mod z square is differentiable only when z equal to 0. So first problem is everywhere differentiable, and second problem, first part, the problem, the function f of z equal to z plus z bar is nowhere differentiable. Now f of z equal to mod z square is differentiable only at one point. So these are the two types of problem, and also there is one more problem we will discuss today, that is finding conjugate. So find analytic function whose imaginary part is v of xy equal to 3x square y minus y cube. So in last lecture we studied, if you have given u, then you can find v. So here we have given the imaginary part, so we have to find out u, so that we can write f equal to u plus iv. That is an analytic function. Solution. So here given v equal to 3x square y minus y cube. Now we will find vx. Vx equal to 6xy. Vy equal to 3x square minus 3y square. Okay. Now we want to find out u. But we know that by Cauchy-Riemann equation, by CR equation, ux is always equal to vy, uy equal to minus vx. Okay. So we have to find out ux. So here vy is equal to this, and that must be equal to ux. It implies ux equal to 3x square minus 3y square. Okay. 3y square. Now we have to find out u. So this is derivative with respect to x, and the function is in two variable x and y. So in order to get u, we will integrate with respect to x. So when we are integrating with respect to x, this y terms are constant. So if you integrate it, integrate on both sides, you will get integral ux is with respect to x is u. If you are integrating with respect to x, 3x cube by 3 minus 3y square x plus. Now here, while we are integrating with respect to x, y terms are constant. Therefore, our arbitrary constant is a function of y, h of y. So here our unknown is h of y. We don't know what is h of y. If we find h of y, then we will get u. So how to find out h of y? We already know that uy equal to minus vx, and we know what is vx. So we will differentiate this with respect to y. So we will get uy. So uy is equal to, if you differentiate this with respect to y, you will get minus 6xy plus h dash of y. And this must be equal to minus vx. Okay, so uy equal to minus vx. Now, what is minus vx? What is vx? Vx equal to 6xy. Right, vx equal to 6xy. Therefore, minus vx is equal to minus 6xy. So which implies, from here we will get minus 6xy plus h dash of y equal to minus 6xy, which implies h dash of y equal to 0. So if you integrate h dash of y with respect to y, we will get, if you integrate on both sides, you will get h of y is equal to a constant k. So our unknown h of y. So therefore u equal to x cube minus 3 y square x plus h of y is k. So this is the harmonic conjugate. Therefore we can write the analytic function f of z is equal to u plus iv, which is equal to x cube minus 3 y square x plus k plus I times, what is v? V is 3x square y minus y cube. 3x square y minus y cube. 3x square y minus y cube. So this is our required analytic function.